All right, people, I think I'm ready. It is time to uncover the gem that was buried for a while in the depths of my hard drive. This is a pure battle against NBZ, the man that I don't think I need to introduce to anybody. There is only one reason why it has been waiting for so long to see a daylight. It's over 50 turns long, which makes it one of the longest pure battles that I've had. Looking on the teams, you can see I'm using a regenerator team, but that is not why this battle was so long, as this time there was no stalling on my side whatsoever. On the opposing side, I immediately recognized Mantler and Eggington, and although I've seen both of them in action before, I don't remember almost anything from that, so it's not like it gives me any form of advantage. Other than that, there are three major PU threats and a Luminion, which is the main reason of the length of this battle, so instead of making it even longer, let's get into it already. As usual, I have chosen Shaq Fu for my leading spot, because at first it doesn't look like he has any reliable checks to it, meaning that I can get some good damage right from the start. Because of his Mantler's Intimidate though, Fake Out doesn't do much, and I know that fully invested in speed he is faster than me, so I decide to hard switch out to Fungus and see what he wants to do. He T-waves me on the switch, which isn't a problem at all, because Fungus being a mushroom won't be outspeeding anything anyway, and my Audino can get rid of any status later on. I decide to go for a stun for myself to cripple something on his team, but it turns out to be even more useless since he brings his Dragonair, and by the way he switched it in, I know that he has Shedskin to remove any status I will try to inflict. So with all that in mind, my plan is to bring my Duosion as he goes for a Dragon Dance and set up a Trick Room so that right after his paralysis is removed, ironically he will be outsped by most of my team. All of that works out just how I wanted, up to the point where I hit him with Psychic, and considering that I am fully invested in special attack and with quiet nature, it does a disappointing amount, but because rather than Life Orb I'm holding Eviolite, I also take plus 2 Waterfall very well. Knowing that as long as Trick Room is up, he probably won't set up more Dragon Dances, I switch back to Fungus, because you know, it's a regenerator team, it's all about switching in and out. I take another Waterfall like it's nothing, and then remove all of his stat boosts with a Clear Smog. He however decides to set up more of them despite that, and this is where things start going uphill for me. First I try to spore him, hoping that despite his Shedskin it will allow me to go for a Clear Smog again, but because it's the last turn of my Trick Room, he wakes up on the very same turn. Now that wouldn't be a big deal, because with max physical investment and Eviolite, I know that I can take any hit from him, but then I get fully paralyzed as he gets up to plus 2 again. That still wouldn't be a big deal, because I can still take any hit from him and after removing his boosts, recover the damage by switching back to Duosion, then set up a Trick Room, etc, etc. But he gets a crit. Now let's stop here for a moment. Most of the times I'll just mention a crit on either of sides and move on with the battle, but this particular crit is very, very significant. In fact, had I seen this coming, I would rather sack anything on my team but Fungus, because it was my answer to Stuntler, Dragonair, Luminion and even Bertic. So I just want you to observe 1 minute silence for a brave mushroom that defended the team till the end. Nah, I'm kidding, but in a nutshell, that crit blows major balls. So now my only option is to go back to Duosion, hope that I can leave plus 2 outrage, set up a Trick Room again, and then hope that he hits himself in confusion. That last bit unfortunately doesn't happen, so Duosion goes down as well, but now with Trick Room up, I go back to Mianfu to finish him off. I go for a Fake Out first, but then he decides to save this thing for later and switches to Eggington. Because High Jump Kick does just below half to him, I go to my Corsola to scout whether he is carrying a Brave Bird. He decides to go for a Toxic though, and then switches back to Dragonair as I bring my Audino to get off a Heal Bell. Since I'm specially defensive and my only attack is a Flamethrower, I decide to go to my Slowpoke, which is pretty much my last resort against this thing. I take his Outrageous surprisingly well and hit him with Zen Headbutt, but it just misses a kill, so then I go for a Slack Off, recover all of the damage, and seeing that its efforts are in vain, his Dragonair commits suicide. Then he brings his Eggington again, and afraid of Dark Pulse, I decide to switch back to Mianfu. He just knocks off my Life Orb though, and because of that, Fake Out combined with Stone Edge is not enough to take him out from this range. He roots off most of the damage and then toxics me before I finally manage to break through this thing with another High Jump Kick and Stone Edge. Right there I make a big mistake though, by assuming that Mienfu outspeeds the Viper and going for a U-turn, because they do in fact have the same base speed stat. He wins the speed tie and straight out revenge kills me with a Venoshock. I go back to Audino, and knowing that I can easily take any hit from him, I go for a Heal Bell just to remove my Corsola's Toxic, so that I can maybe try to set up with it later on. He switches back to Stuntler and T-waves me for some reason, and then goes for a Thunderbolt, which for a super effective damage does a pitiful amount to my slow power, so I get an open window to set up all I want. So despite that he sets up a Reflect now, some of you might see a late game Slowpoke sweep coming, but it turns out that Naps has one more ace up his sleeve that can prevent that from happening. That ace is his Lumineon, because this isn't just any Lumineon, if any Lumineon is even a thing itself. This is a fucking sub-toxic Whirlpool Lumineon. Now, I have seen a lot of weird shit in Pew over the months, so there is not a lot left that can surprise me, but this, I am lost for words. Just see for yourself. This is exactly why my Fungus getting credit is so significant, because had it been still alive, none of that nonsense you just witnessed wouldn't have happened, since it utterly and completely walled this thing. So with my Slowpoke going down, my chances of winning this battle went from slim to none. Realizing that, I bring my Corsola and set up a Calm Mind as he toxics me again. Thankfully, since this thing seems to be fully physically defensive, he decides to switch to Seviper, which saves us another turn of stalling. I hit him with a Power Gem, which does a decent amount at plus 1, but his Giga Drain is painfully obvious, so I'm forced to switch back to Audino to take it. Then I go for a Toxic, predicting him to switch out, because I can easily Life Orb stall him, but even that proves to be harder than it seems, because I get fully paralyzed twice in a row, and then critted as I switch to Corsola, just to regain a bit of HP with Regenerator, but none of that doesn't matter at this point, because as I said, this battle was over for me after my Slowpoke went down. I go back to Audino once again, just so his Seviper goes down to his Life Orb recoil, but then Lieutenant Bird comes in and destroys me with a superpower. So Corsola, used once in a blue moon by Pokemon players, is the last one standing on my side of the field, facing three still strong Pokemon, takes a Thunderbolt from Manly Mantler himself, but is not able to answer with the same kind of power, as Power Gem does barely any damage, but instead of just ending these tortures, in comes Lumineon, laughing in his face and saying, "You've got to do better than that," then throws him into a Whirlpool as he's fighting with continuously racking up toxic damage, but the harder the exhausted Corsola tries to hit his opponent, the louder he laughs at him, until finally, Lieutenant Bird says, "That's enough," seeing the toxic damage taking the last signs of life from Blue Moon, and so, the battle ends. There is no need to add anything. If you enjoyed, this like button and comment box is for you to show it, and as always, I see you all next time.